Hi everyone, welcome to Medical Microbiology. Today we will discuss chapter 4, survey of prokaryotic microorganisms. On the first lecture, we're going to learn a little bit about living things. So all living things will have these five characteristics. And these characteristics distinguish between living things and non-living things. Living things will have this characteristic, the non-living things will not have this characteristic. The first characteristic is all living things grow and develop. Okay, so growing means it's become bigger or taller by adding more cells. Development means these living things, so some of them, like for example humans, cells that growing, they also differentiate into different organs. There are cells that become liver, the heart, the lungs, and etc. So this is development. The second characteristic of life is movement and irritability. So all living things has the ability to respond to the stimulus. They have the ability to move, whether a whole body movement, like human move from one place to another place, or movement inside the body, like for example, movement of water inside the plants, okay, from the roots to the leaf. The third characteristic of life is all living things has the ability to support themselves. Like for example, they have the ability to absorb the food, find the food, eat the food, okay? They have the ability to transport materials, chemicals, molecules from outside to inside or from inside to outside the cell. They also have the ability to protect themselves by producing enzymes, antibodies, and etc. So these are the characteristic of life, the third characteristic of life. The fourth characteristic of life is metabolism. What is metabolism? Metabolism is all chemical reaction that presents in the cell or in the body. There are two types of metabolism. Okay, the first one is called anabolism. Okay, anabolism means synthesis reaction. So this is the reaction that builds bigger molecule from smaller molecule. And the second metabolism will be catabolism. This is the chemical reaction that break the bigger molecule into smaller molecule, or this is also known as decomposition. So all living things will have this ability to perform metabolism. And the fifth or the last characteristic will be reproduction and heredity. So all living things have the ability to reproduce, because with their reproduction, they will stay in this world. So make them become exist. If they are unable to reproduce, then they undergo extinction. So reproduction means production of new individual, okay? And heredity is related to the ability to transfer the gene, the characteristic from parents to the offspring. So these are the five characteristics of life. All life, okay, or living thing, they consist of cell, right? Consists of cell. So cell is actually the smaller unit of living. All living thing will have cell. There are some organisms that only have one cell. Okay, single cell organism or sometimes is also known as unicellular organism. The organism that only have one cell and they able to perform all the five characteristic of life. Example is all bacteria will be single cell, and there are some organism is called protozoa, algae, they also single cell organism, okay, or unicellular organism. The second type of organism is called the multicellular organism, the organism that has a lot of cells in their body. Like human, for example, human is multicellular organism because human have trillion of cells. Okay, so this is the second type of organism, multicellular organism. Now all cells have the shape, okay, how it look like. Basically, there are three basic shape of cell. The first one is look like a ball, round, it's called the spherical. The second one is look like a cube. Okay, it's a cubical. And the last one is look like a cylinder. It's long cell. Okay, this is cylindrical. Okay, so these are the three basic shapes. But there are other shapes, like there are some cell that look like a spiral. Okay. So there are some cells that look like a crescent moon. But again, there are three basic shape of cell, okay? Round, cubical, or cylindrical. All these cells, okay, will have some similarities. The first one will be, okay, all cells will have the boundary. Okay, that boundary is called the cell membrane. So all cell will have the cell membrane. The second, okay, all cell will have the cell contents, which is called the cytoplasm. So this is cytoplasm. This is a cytoplasm. Okay, the content of the cell is called the cytoplasm that mostly consists of water. And then all cell will have the chromosome. Okay, because all cell have the ability to reproduce and to transfer the gene. So this gene is actually located in the chromosome. So therefore all cell will have the chromosome. This is chromosome. And all cell will have the small organelle that able to produce proteins. That organelle is called ribosomes. So all cell will have ribosome. So there are again four structure that will be present in all cell, which is the first one is cell membrane, the second one is the cytoplasm, and the third one is the chromosome, and the fourth one is the ribosome. So all of these four structure will be present in all type of cell. There are two main basic type of cell. The first one is called the eukaryotic cell. The second one is called the prokaryotic cell. Eukaryotic cell means this cell has nucleus and other organelles inside the cell. Eukaryotic cell actually mean, okay, nucleus. They have real nucleus. You mean real. Okay, karyon mean nucleus. Okay, so from the name, then we know that eukaryotic cell mean the cell that have real nucleus. Prokaryotic cell, okay, pro mean before, okay, pro mean before, and karyon mean nucleus. So it means that this cell do not have nucleus. Okay, do not have nucleus. Now what is nucleus? Nucleus is actually the chromosome plus the envelope that protect the chromosome. So when the chromosome is protected by this structure, the envelope, then it become nucleus. Okay, so eukaryotic cell will have this nucleus, while the prokaryotic cell will not have the nucleus. Okay, now we're gonna compare these two type of cell, prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Now, just for information, for easy remember that only one organism that have prokaryotic type of cell, which is bacteria. Okay, just remember that all bacteria they are prokaryotic cell. The rest of organism will be having the eukaryotic type of cell. So like protists, fungi, plant and animal, okay, all of these organisms will have eukaryotic type of cells. So just for easy memorization, all prokaryotic cell will be bacteria and eukaryotic cell will be all other organisms, okay, protists, fungi, plants, and animals. Now, we're going to see the similarities first, okay? All cells, remember, they will have the cell membrane. So it doesn't matter whether prokaryotic or eukaryotic cell, a cell will have the cell membrane, similar, the same cell membrane. Then the second structure will be cytoplasm. So all cells will have cytoplasm, the cell contents. And all cell will carry chromosome because all cell have the ability to reproduce and transfer their gene. So therefore they will have the chromosome. And all cell will have the ribosome, which is the organelle that used for making proteins. So these are the four similarities and the four structure that presents in prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Now the differences will be the eukaryotic cell, their chromosome will be protected by the nuclear envelope. So this is nuclear envelope. Protect the chromosome. And this whole organ, this whole structure become nucleus. So nucleus is actually chromosome that is protected by the envelope. So this is the nucleus now, and this is only present in the eukaryotic cell. And eukaryotic cell also have other organelles. What is organelle? Organelle is small organ inside the cell that has special function. So, like for example here, eukaryotic cell will have rough ER, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Yeah. And this rough ER has a function to store the proteins. Okay. Remember ribosome, they produce the protein and it will be stored in the RER. And the next organelles in the eukaryotic cell is smooth ER. The function of smooth ER is to produce proteins and lipids. Okay. And then there is another bigger organelle over here. It's called the Golgi apparatus. The function of Golgi apparatus is to modify lipids, proteins, and carbohydrates into final products like enzymes and hormones. So Golgi apparatus actually will take the protein from RER, the lipid and carbohydrate from the SER, and then it will modify that molecules into a new product. So basically, Golgi apparatus is the factory inside the cell that produces enzymes, hormones, okay, and other products. There is another or other smaller organelles like lysosome. Lysosome carry enzyme, it's called the lysozyme, that used for destroying bacteria. Maybe there is bacteria that enter into eukaryotic cell, it will be destroyed by this lysosome. There is another organelle, it's called peroxisome. It's carry enzyme that destroy the toxin or drugs. Okay, so this is for detoxification. And there is other smaller organelle, it's called the proteasome. This is the organelle that will destroy the extra unnecessary proteins. Okay, so like for example, maybe ribosome produce some unnecessary proteins will be removed or destroyed by this proteasome. And there is mitochondria, which is the organelle that produce the energy, ATP, for all the process inside the cell. Okay, mitochondria is the power, okay, the power plant inside the cell. There is also organelles like chloroplast that only present in plant, okay, and algae, and this organelle is used for making carbohydrate, the food, okay, glucoses. So these are the differences between prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. Okay, so again, there are two types of cell, eukaryotic cell, including animal, plant, fungi, and protist. And protist consists of protozoa, okay, which is a primitive organism that look like animal, and algae, which is a primitive organism that look like plant. Okay, so that's protist. And prokaryotic cell, of course, all bacteria. Bacteria are prokaryotic organism. Okay, so remember in chapter 4, we will learn about the prokaryotic cell structure. Okay, so there are three main structures. The first one is called the external structure, which is the structure that located outside the cell. And usually used for maybe protection, attachment, movement, and etc. The second one is called the cell envelope, which is the boundary of the cell. For the prokaryotic cell, remember bacteria. Okay, so prokaryotic cell will be bacteria. They have two membranes, which is the cell wall and the cell membrane. And the last one will be internal structure, the structure inside the cell, of course, cytoplasm, chromosome, and ribosome. And there is other structure like plasmid that only present in bacteria, inclusions and granules, cytoskeleton, and some bacteria has the ability to produce the endospore, which is the structure that is really difficult to destroy, to kill. Okay? So these are the structure of prokaryotic cell. We will learn this on the second lecture. Okay, so we finish our first lecture, then we will meet again on the second lecture, which is basic structure of the prokaryotic cell. Goodbye now.